All right, video is starting, honey. So if you say anything, you'll be on camera. I'm gonna try to paint this picture, right? Taken in Gourdet, Provence.
Provence.
Canvas check. Thing that I made to hold my canvas and my paints. Double check. So I wanted to show the camera this because this has been really nice because then I can just paint in different places. I also have tea, which is very good. Chamomile tea. So anyways, what you have to do is, I like these. And then, got different brushes. I want to try to think about which colors are on this thing. So I see yellow. I see a kind of peach color in that rock. I'm going to put those all like that. Right? Now I'm going to try to paint this fast. Okay. So I'm gonna like try to see if I can just like paint this fast, because I don't like painting for forever. And I think you paint better when you paint fast, or at least when you don't think about it so hard, and you have that you paint in the genre that you are. The genre that I'm using is the one that requires me to paint like a little faster. See, does he need to burp? Mm-hmm. He's burping. This is a cool color, that like pastel blue, or that like
That was pretty.
I'm probably gonna really not make that color correctly, but we shall see. Beep, beep, beep. Once I get all these cutos in the hole, did I already put this in? Oh wow, no, I didn't. That's yet another blue. Put that down here. That's awesome. I don't know if I need that much blue. I can't believe how green whatever. I don't know if you can see it, but that's so green back there. So, but then I'm gonna just go like this. I'm gonna take a. Yeah, it doesn't work. You can't zoom in like that.
No, you could.
Apparently not. I'm gonna Oh yeah, I like this color. I can't find the top to this, so I keep having to puncture it. Alexa, go to the next song. Alexa, go to the next song. Sounds like a good one for painting this. I'm just gonna use this color because of my outline. So I'm just gonna go like there, and it looks like it's like right there-ish. Why does it go up? This is my canvas size. The size of this picture. That's okay. Can't win them all. This is a really good song. Alexa, what is this song?
This is Don't Wake Me Up. Solo piano version by Wide Eye.
Play this song for our wedding.
Oh yeah. Whoops, I just took some of my yellow. It's fine, whatever. Doggone it, that left me like no space. It's fine. This canvas is such a weird. I guess, I'm gonna come down here with this. There. Do you love the perspective in this painting, or in this picture, or what, honey?
I do. Yeah, that's beautiful.
Isn't that insane?
Makes me feel like I'm upstairs looking out a window, which is yeah. Exactly what you're doing.
So these streets in Gorday are, it's a city that's built on a mountain, or on like a, the hills of Provence are just, they're like the Smoky Mountains, but more rocks, and so they just have like, all of a sudden you'll have like this huge thing that goes up in the sky, and they were like, hey, we should build a town on that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's beautiful. I like how
everything's
just built up into mountains.
Oh, I know. So, it's very cozy.
So, is this a place in the village your grandparents lived, or nearby, or where is
They're
this?
They're not actually that close to Provence. Comar and Villeurbanne. Crazy. I got that totally wrong. It literally goes up. That is insane.
It goes up.
It does. Compared to, well, okay. Now I have to put the skyline in.
The building is taller than what you're painting on.
The building is taller?
Mm-hmm. Like you need to bring the wall down further a little bit.
This building is taller?
Yeah.
So I need to bring it down?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
See the corner of the two buildings are right next to each other. See? The bottoms of the buildings are the same. Yeah, there you go.
Is that right?
Do you think?
The bottoms of the buildings right here?
Yeah. See how they're the same?
Yeah.
There you go.
I guess you're right, but this building like curves around because there's like a walled, like a stone wall there.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, now I have like the basic structure of this thing. I can put in where my thing's gonna go. I'm gonna put out my thing right there. Kind of ish. This thing. Close enough. Really not close enough. But anyways, now I'm gonna take a bigger brush and I'm gonna put some sky in real quick. So I'm gonna use white. Put this. I should like move this whole thing over because I'm like twisting. This video. It's taking too long. I should be done with this painting by now. Quick, insert sky. Put sky in there. I'm just gonna put like just a hair. See, because like my camera. Did not pick up sky. Is he okay?
Yeah. It's okay, buddy. It's okay.
My camera was like so focused on the other colors that were happening that it didn't care about the sky. This was an overcast day anyways, so it wasn't that colorful of a day. That's gonna have to do for now. That works for now. Okay, there's my sky. Boom. Now I need a bunch of green, so I'm gonna just put green on. A bunch of different. I'm gonna put blue on there too, blue and green. That's not the color I wanted, so I need a different kind of green. I'm gonna put this green on. actually need like yellow in my green, believe it or not, to get the color that I need. So I'm gonna put that in now. Now that's like closer. Boing, 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 boing. That's like closer. This bright color with this in here. Oh yeah, look at that. Oh my gosh. That is literally, that's the color. That's what it is. It's so bright. I'm using white with that crazy green to get this color. Zoink. It's also got some dark. Too excited about that yet. Okay, now maybe I can use a different brush here and I'll paint this whole buggy building. Actually not the smallest canvas. I would like for it to have been smaller, I think. Fewer places I can touch on this thing. And I think one of the big things at this stage is getting the paint on there. One of my big fears when I'm painting is that I will waste paint. And I think I still have that fear, but it's one of the things that makes me not paint correctly. So but the other thing is like trying to get the texture right. I'm always trying to get the texture right up front. And I think that the texture is something that can wait, like typically. So for these paintings, I'm not going to go crazy. Like I'm just destroying my little, they weren't really good indicators of where things should go anyways. I didn't really do that correctly. Let me just slow down. I need to slow down. Sometimes I can go too fast, or I can be a little bit reckless, or kind of like just destructive, I guess. I don't want to do that. I don't want to be like that. There's probably... Who's that? I don't know who that was. Text message there. I'm like filling this whole scene with this flippin' color of brown-ish. Whoops. So now I've got like some of the stuff in place. I'm gonna put some stuff up here because there's buildings up there. And I'm gonna put like, I'm just gonna put some things there. Right. Okay, now I'm gonna put like, I'm just gonna use a couple, I'm gonna use like blue. Always put more color on there. I don't know why I put blue in there. It's not turning out correctly. I'm gonna have to put some white. Actually, I do need to put some, you know, maybe this is a good time to revisit. Nah, you know what? I'm going to keep going. I'm going to put more of this stuff on here because I've got tons of it. I'm just going to go like that. Now, is this, I'll just step back. Is this in line with, are all my things in line? I don't know. Time will tell. Some purple with this. This may not be the correct idea. Sometimes dark is just color that isn't spread out. I mean, dark is just like a light color that is thick. I shouldn't have put a little thing down here. There's so many different greens in this picture, babe. It's crazy.
Yeah.
It's hard to feel like, yeah. It's just hard to feel like you're capturing the right, like, contrast of just so many different greens. Now this actually goes way up to the top of the picture, so I'm gonna pull it way up. Why not? Saline, okay. You know, I should probably put on some. It's actually like higher, I think. Is it higher? Is she okay? Did he really need that? I mean, isn't he?
Yeah.
I haven't heard him sniffle. Think this needs to be higher. Maybe it doesn't. You know what? I'm not gonna make it higher. I just am not gonna put this in. Put some little things like that in here. Just get some more from the tube. It's fine. Right, that's probably too much, but it's fine. Okay, we're at 23 minutes. I want to get this painting done fast, so. I'm going to put some paint up here. Oh, I need some, like, burnt umber, some red. I have burnt umber somewhere, but here it is. Roussillon. There's a town nearby this town called Roussillon, which is, I bet it means red something. I can't believe I don't remember what it means, but I know it means red something. Anyway, it was a red town, literally red. Just the whole town was built for this red rock, and there was a red quarry out back, the Roussillon Quarry. If you want to search Roussillon, it's spelled with T two S's and an R-O-U, I want to say. Anyways, this color is my big color in this painting. And I am going to move this tripod in a little bit. And I'll move this over like this. Oh, I love this song. White in here. Sure how to capture that detail of white. It's very, very light limestone white. It's not quite white, you know, like you would think. Let's fool around with this. I don't know what's in here. There's a bunch of weird colors in here. Some brown, I think I see. Some brown. Let's put some brown and red. Ooh, there's a tree in here. Yeah. There's actually some green. So let's get the green back out. Yeah, get some of this. Let's mix green and brown. Suggestion of more than trees, which there is more than trees in there, but again, I'm not being like really specific with this painting, so this weird bluish color that I made, which I hated at first, but now I like, and fill this puppy in. But actually, I'm gonna make it even darker. Hoi-yo, because there's a nice little shadow right here. Look at the shadow. It's cool if I can make a shadow blue. Why not? Pull it out, pull it down. Okay. Now, yeah, that's fine. That's okay. That's, yeah, whatever. So, now, I'm actually going to pull, I'm going to use this color to, nope, I don't like that. I need black. I need this to be even darker. Oh, lamp black? Why not? I don't spend very much money on paints, and I probably should. So, that's a comment. Just for a derp, 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 derp. And so these, let's see how that looks. Let's see how that looks. That looks fine. Right now, I want to get this window out of the way. I'm probably going to screw this up. See that window? Boom. It's kind of what it looks like. Okay, and then I got more windows down here. This door down here is like really black. So is this little thing, whatever it is, I don't know what it is. But I like it. Oh man, I screwed that up. Oh well. And then I've got actually like a really, I don't even know what this is over here. It's just like very, very dark. So I'm gonna mix some green and some, I'm mixing green and brown and black in. I'm gonna put this over here so that I have a background of darkness. That's one of the darkest, this is one of the darkest spots in the whole painting. This area back here, why is it so dark? I don't know. I think shadows, you know? Oh yeah, I like that color actually. That's a very cool color. I need more of that green. Let's put some more green in there. Put some more, wait, I need more green. And some yellow. See, am I keeping my, can you see that okay? All right. Oh man, we're at 32. This might be a longer video. I hope it's not too long. Yellow, boing.
Yeah.
Yellow. I like that color. I'm gonna put more of that in here. And I'm gonna put some of that even over here. Because I like it so much. And then I'm gonna use that up here for this. That's fine, I guess. I mean, this should be more steep, I think, so I can have more room. Try to get myself a nice edge there. It's gonna be hard, but whatever. Little edge, okay. Now, this is an interesting place up here. I like this color from here because it's a very fadey. It's like not very ambitiously green. Where else can I use that? That's another thing I do is when I don't have anywhere else to use that color, I like try to force that color into places where I shouldn't put that color because I don't want to waste the paint. So I think what I want to say about being scared of wasting paint is that is a bad thing. I think it's like not a good thing. I think I like this song too. This is Oliver Arnold's We Contain Multitudes. Just a really sweet, soft song. And I don't know what colors are in here. Lots of different colors. It's hard to see all the colors in there. Sure if that was a good idea or not, but it is done. So now, how is this gonna work? Is that correct? Something like that. Something right there. It can just look like so terrible for so long too. That's another thing that I learned, that like it's fine for if it looks terrible, because eventually, for one thing, that gives you like freedom to be like, well, it already looks terrible, so I guess I can't make it any worse. So then you just are like, cool, I can do whatever I want. And that kind of attitude of like, cool, I can do whatever I want, actually is what I think makes the best paintings. When you're like, oh no, I'm gonna ruin this thing, that's when your paintings are like, they just look weird. Probably a good metaphor for trusting God in there. I think like when we're like, oh no, I'm not doing this right, I need to like, well, maybe I should say it differently. I think when we obsess about our performance, like, there's a kind of hypervigilance that creates not goodness. Whatever goodness comes from that is a lot of times, I think, contrived, and that means that it is not good. It's so hard to create this texture because it's like almost white, and yet it's not white. I love this picture though. Squares or something, I don't know. Create little squares, maybe? Is that gonna work? I can do this. Take this down into that thing. And then pull that in so that it blends. Because that red is not quite that red. It's almost more yellow. I can introduce some yellow. Sure, why not? Put some yellow down there. Why not? Use the old finger method. Not usually advised. Whoops. Didn't want to do that. Let's see if we can fix that. So anyways, that's cool. Now, 45 minutes. I guess I should drink more tea. Than there is in this painting, and that's a little bit of concern to me. So I think what I want to do is take a brush that I have. Well, yeah, I'll take a new brush, and I'm gonna go like this. Texture. That is my next best guess of how to clean this thing up. It's not that white. But it needs to be more white than brown, like the, or yellow, whatever. It's too yellow. Too yellow, people. Much too yellow, everybody. Not as yellow. And these spots up here, do I care as much about these? Nah, I do not. I'm going to actually use this thing. I'm going to use this brush, I think. What does this have on it? Some weird color. Some dark color. Do this. It's like a bunch of weird flipping flippers. These things in. Sometimes squinting your eyes can help. You realize when you squint your eyes that there's actually a checkered kind of thing happening with these. So I'm gonna try to do the checkered thing. Then I'm going to put in some reddish peach colors in order to create the checkered thing that I want. Don't have enough paint on my brush. That's part of the problem. Mm-hmm. bunch of red. I like it though. I think I like it. I think I like this. Some white. Yeah. Why not, man? I like it. Nice and red in some spots. A little too much. Oh well, it's fine. I'm going to put more orange in here. I'm going to put some yellow in with this. And I'm going to create this light white color, which is right on the edge. It's not very light, so let's try again. Still not very light. Whatever. And then I'm gonna try. I don't know if there's enough of a contrast there. Maybe there is. Maybe there's not. It's tough to say. I need more white. My painting is too dark. Sorry. I think I need to. Oh no, there goes my pen. Kind of did something incorrect. So now this is what happens when this happens. So there's red on my painting now. There are a couple things you can do at this point. You can turn the video off and go to bed, which is probably what I'm going to do. Or you can try to clean that up. And I think I'm gonna turn the video off and go to bed. Although, yeah, I think it's, yeah, because this video is almost an hour long and it wasn't supposed to be that long. So that is how you create part of a painting and then destroy part of it. So, okay, but yeah, I'm gonna try and make another video, I think, finishing up this painting. I think I will do that, but that's enough for tonight.